Hello. As you know, I have another video here. The question is that I have a letter from the Victorian University. The question that I need to put is that there seems to be a lack from universities to acquire under the law, which would say the Disability Discrimination Amendment Education Standard Act 2005. Now, it does state that under this section, under 1C, after subsection 31C, inserts 1C, 1A, 1B, and 1C, for avoidance of doubt, unjustifiable hardship does not excuse an education provider from complying with the requirements made for disability standards under subsection. This does not affect the implications of operation of section 32 in relation to other contraventions of disability standards. As 1A says, for the avoidance of doubt, a disability standards may require a person or body dealing with the person with the disability to put in place reasonable adjustments to eliminate as far as possible discrimination against those persons. Now, I don't believe the Victorian University has put in reasonable place or adjustments to eliminate as far as possible discrimination against myself or against other people. My concern is I believe strongly that other people will get discriminated. Now, I receive a letter. Now, I'm not too concerned about the first one. The two recent written references, well, I don't have any written references because this has been my job for over 14 years. This is my job that I've had for over 14 years. Now, at the end of the day, that is my job. And what I don't understand is that the university is somewhat discriminating on the grounds of my disability. I was speaking to a professor, Marty Grace, the head social work unit, School of Social Science and Psychology. Now, for instance, she says that she has worked in social work education, women's creativity, women's unpaid work, youth homelessness. Now, I'm aware of the homelessness issue, as I may have to go into Melbourne and Lonsdale Street to actually do a partition as well as lobby in Lonsdale Street with the Housing Minister of Victoria over the fact that their policy is one of homelessness and they really don't care about the Victorian people. Now, I've contacted the Federal Minister for Tertiary Education and he is getting on to this matter. What I find very difficult is the Victorian University, including this professor here, which is on public websites. There you have it there. And she's actually the professor for my degree. So I believe in so many matters. She turned around and said to me, Cameron, maybe social work's not for you. And maybe you shouldn't be doing this. If she's got this so-called qualifications, then maybe she has to have listening skills as well and understand that this has been my passion and I believe in helping people no matter whatever cost. I will help anyone. I think that at the end of the day, I have cried from the rooftops and I'm asking for to go back to university to do my degree, which is a Bachelor of Community Work. I believe that in some senses that the university is possibly breaching the Disability Discrimination Amendment Education Standards Act of 2005 and other discrimination laws. I merely want to go back and do my education. And merely I would like to know why the Victorian University has a policy in place which somewhat underneath the Disability Standards Act that it says, for avoidance of doubt, disability standards may require a person or body dealing with a person with a disability to put in place reasonable adjustments to eliminate as far as possible discriminating against those persons. Discriminating against me. I think that I don't have an issue. What my issue is here is they are asking for somebody with a disability to go as far as this. They're not willing to sit down and have a roundtable meeting and discuss the issues at hand They're only interested in how they can discriminate and how they can prejudge me and have judgment against me. And judge me for what? They have no evidence. They don't know who I am. Basically, my life is one of human rights, social justice, and I will help anyone out there that needs help. My job is an advocate by law. I have this card that I carry with me wherever I go and whatever I do. I will look at things like mental health issues, Centrelink, police, correctional services, aged care, complaints to do with any issues, filing documents for courts, forms for courts or any other areas, tribunals reports, letter writing, homelessness, court support, family support, tenancy, disability, self-advocacy, education work, Centrelink, to be your voice. Young person support, advocacy supports, transport needs. Now, at the end of the day, I don't give people this card out. And what for? Why would I give people my business card out if I'm not what it says? What my objection here is, I have a Victorian university that is somewhat breaching the disability discrimination laws, will not see any other avenue but to discriminate. Now, in my letter here, it says, to whom may be concerned, federal ministers, Centrelink ministers, education centre, I ask for your support of any assistance you can provide for us so I can move forward. Now, in my letters here, just getting the rest of the letter that I've just recently written, it states here, to the ministers, Chris Evans, to whom may be concerned, senators and media, I'm hoping that I can attend the university next year, that's Victorian University. I'd like to know that's why I am tarred with the same brush and the Victorian University making it difficult as long as I, in the long run, I will be disadvantaged. I'm not given the opportunity to go back to university because of policy and procedures breaking the law at Victorian University. I like to be treated fairly with justice and able to complete a degree. I've already experienced in this degree, as I'm already voluntarily do this, and I do not get paid for helping people. I'd like a full investigation into this matter, and that I have a nice lady called Maria Vardakis, which is trying to help me, as difficult as for her as well as the university to make her job hard. I ask that they're able to attend university next year and complete my degree, and hoping that I have full support of the government and that I'm able to be encouraged to complete education. It is a quite frustrating process as the university procedures and policy regarding this matter cause injustice and leaves people vulnerable and without assistance or support. In turn, people are left behind and denied education because the university is tarring everybody with the same brush. I believe in doing this so the university may not deny me because of my communicating or making a complaint. I ask to be treated fairly, equitably, and treated like anyone else. I ask to organise a verbal roundtable meeting and resolve this matter and able to go on and get an education. I'm wanting help to get an education. I am trying to get education and policy procedures not help. I hope my constitutional rights are not being eroded as well as that the university may proceed to break these laws. Please help and support me and any other in the same circumstances before the law and human rights, then people are denied education because of policy and procedures interfering with the education process of rights of education. The news article is when I was hit by a police car at the same time. I have a house in university area. I live in Victoria University and wish to go to university, so I am in this area. The generic letter impedes a person's rights of education and causes does not provide reasonable adjustment to eliminate discrimination against those persons. This is where policy and procedures are denying myself going back to education. Please, I wish to return to university to solve this matter, so I ask for any ways to deal with this matter. I request for a meeting with the faculty concerned and around the meeting to address these concerns and answer they may have. I ask for the ministers to investigate and a full audit into the Victorian University to reassure the Australian people are able to go to do education and that everyone is entitled not to be discriminated on the grounds of your disability. I ask the ministers to revisit the system process. Victoria University consider that I may not be treated unfairly and not being not listened to. and the law being broken. Please help me attend university. I have been told by Marty Grace that I should apply elsewhere, that they believe this is not for me, and prejudge me of my disability and not treat me according to the law, but treat me according to their laws, not government laws. I request for a roundtable meeting to resolve this issue, mediation that I can attend the university. As I said, the disability discrimination, it is unlawful for an education provider to discriminate against a person on the grounds of the person's disability or disabilities, any person associated. At the end of the day, why is it this university can continue to behave in this way, somewhat cause frustration and somewhat not willing to understand or have any flexibility? Under the Disability Discrimination Amendment Education Standards Act of 2005, the Act was amended by the Disability Discrimination Act of 1992 and related purposes. At the end of the day, I'd like to know if I can attend university, and I will go on to part two of this matter in just in a short second.